Julian Glover, alias Christatos, nice to have you with us this evening. Now, how does someone from a traditional theatrical background of Stratford and Avon and the West End and all those great classical roles end up as a baddie in a Bond film?
Well, the reason I got this one was because I played arguably the nicest person of the 20th century, Alexander Dubček of Czechoslovakia, and the producer of the film, Cubby Broccoli, saw this and thought I would be absolutely right for the villain in the James Bond film. Something went wrong somewhere along the line, because if I'm going to play a nice person, then I get the villain. I don't quite know what happened, but I got it, and I'm well pleased.
Without giving too much away, Julian, this is a villain with a difference. It's not in the classical Bond mould, is it?
No, he's not. I mean, he doesn't have laser beams coming out of his nose and steel teeth and things like that. He's a recognisable animal as a human being. He's very rich, which is not very recognisable. A Greek businessman who deals in all sorts of very legitimate things, but we discover later that he deals in other things which perhaps he shouldn't be, and he has a very cruel personal streak. But that doesn't necessarily make him the villain, you see. That's the great thing about this picture. You don't actually know who the villain is until about two-thirds of the way through the picture.
I've got to quote something at you.
Oh.
Charming, enigmatic, ruthless, and urbane. That apparently is Christatos, but how much of that is
my
you?
My wife would echo all that. I think that's absolutely straight down the line. No, well, that's the idea, that he should be very nice. He should be a very nice, recognisable guy. And in fact, he's engaged in promoting a young skater to win the Olympics, and he's putting all his money into that, and that's what he wants very much. And he seems to be totally altruistic in all his attitudes, but then later on things change slightly, and Bond believes him to be the person he seems to be, and but then there is another person as well in the film who also may not be what he seems to be, and that, I think, is the difference in this picture between the normal Bond film and this one.
We better not give away too much
of
the plot.
No.
We want the paying customers, don't we?
Absolutely. Come on.
You nearly didn't get this job, didn't you?
I nearly didn't get this job because I was doing a film in Greece and I didn't have any time off to come and see the producers of the film. But suddenly one morning, a Saturday morning at 12 o'clock, I realised that I might be able to get a plane from Athens to London, and I got here, did the interview on the Sunday morning at 10 o'clock in the morning, got the plane out at 1 o'clock, and I was back on the set at 5 o'clock on the Monday morning in Greece, five hours from Athens, and I got the part, thank God.
Have you had any sort of criticism from your theatrical friends?
You mean adverse criticism?
That's right.
No, I've had nothing but adulation. I mean, not adulation. They've been thrilled for me. To do a job like this is a job in a lifetime.
Julian Glover, Christatos, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.